let me first give my personal condolences to you, Madam Rajavi, and to all of your family who represent the MEK. I feel at a loss for words right now because my government has failed to live up to its promise to protect your family members, your compatriots at Camp Ashraf. This is not only a moral outrage, but I would propose it's a challenge legally to the world, and it is also a national security issue. You cannot separate this challenge from the challenge as a world. We have the largest state sponsor of terrorism dedicated to creating nuclear weapons. At the same time, they are exporting terrorism and supporting Syria in their brutal assault of the Syrian people. They're executing their own members in Iran, and they're executing people in other countries like the MEK in Camp Ashraf. Do we not see a pattern here? It's all connected. And what I would propose to all of you is that this is a challenge for all of us, whether you come from the United States or whether you come from any of the countries represented here in the Council of Europe. We all have a responsibility. We have a moral responsibility to these innocent people who were disarmed by the Allies, had no way of defending themselves. We have a legal obligation because under the Fourth Geneva Convention, we put our word behind their protection. And we have a national security imperative because they represent the best hope of a future Iran that will not pursue these draconian policies of exporting terrorism and creating a nuclear weapon. We all must stand with you, Madam Rajavi. And we must first stand with you by ensuring the safe release of those 7 hostages. We know the reporting. We have expert witnesses, like former UN official Tahir Boumediene. We don't need any more case law or evidence to know that Iraq is lying about whether it is holding these hostages. We know Iraq is holding these 7 hostages. And the fact that the United States of America is not speaking out when the United States of America was the one responsible to putting Nouri al-Maliki in power is an affront to the United States' reputation around the world, and it's an affront to all free peoples that we could deny that these facts exist and we do nothing to correct these situations. So I would join Brian in calling all of you, as well as I also call my own government, to suspend any foreign aid to Iraq while these 7 hostages remain imprisoned by the Iraqi government. How many martyrs must there be before the conscience of Europe and before the conscience of the United States and before the conscience of the world is raised to pay attention to the plight of these innocent, defenseless persons who are ostensibly protected under the Fourth Geneva Convention? How long must we wait before, as a body, the European Council and the United States live up to its charter to protect human rights? Because that is what this charter of the Council on Europe is about, is human rights. And as you said, Brian, words are over. We need actions by the United States, and we need actions by you members of the Council of Europe to make sure there are no more victims. And we don't have time to waste. I will plead my case with the United States to take up a resolution to suspend foreign aid to Iraq. And I would hope that as council members in the European Parliament and as Council of Europe, you would prevail upon your countries to also suspend the generous foreign aid that the European community gives to Iraq for the rebuilding of their country. How dare they look at us for any more foreign aid while they blatantly violate human rights and the international agreements, such as the Fourth Geneva Convention. 52 additional martyrs, all of whom have family around the world, and we must all be their brothers and sisters and never let their memory die, as the Iraqi government and the Iranian regime hope that they do. We are stronger than ever before. And instead of killing the message of Ashraf, which is hope and liberty for Iran, they reignited a passion within those who want to see a free Iran. Because you may kill those 52, but you'll never kill the dream of Ashraf, which is for a free Iran, free for people to live in liberty and peace and celebrate humanity. That is the reason they died. And let us make sure they didn't die in vain.